This is Roosevelt Gist with Auto Network, and we're here in Death Valley at the Furnace Creek Inn for another leg of the rally with BMW for the 5 Series. And my guest for this segment is Rich Brackus, the General Manager of Product Strategy for BMW. Rich, thanks for taking some time.
Yeah, my pleasure. Thanks for coming with us.
Now, I drove over in the M5.
Red car.
Now, what are some of the things that I should have been looking for in that car driving from Las Vegas to Death Valley?
Well, I think, first, I got to think about the roads you were on. So there were a lot of very long, sweeping curves, very nice road surface. Most of it was pretty smooth, but a lot of dips and everything else in the road, and a lot of camber changes as you went along, so you could feel where the road had different undulations. And I think one of the things that will come across right away is how much the car talks to you, really tells you what's going on, gives you a sense for where the road goes, how the car wants to respond to it, and you get sort of a rhythm, if you will, as you drive. You can feel it, it's alive in the steering wheel, and you just get a sense between from your butt, which is one of the most sensitive things that you can drive with, to your hands, basically what's happening, what the road surface is doing. The car's always talking to you, you're always talking back, and you kind of get that feeling of a flow as you go along. It's never obtrusive. It's never isolationist either. So you just have that nice sense of enjoying the road, if you will, and having a nice ride.
Now, when you think M, obviously you think speed. I think the speed, the legal speed limit out here, the highest was 70 miles per hour. Even though we kind of hit the M button and kicked it up to 120.
Your license, not mine, so yeah. But yeah, it's a very fast car. It's speed limited at 155, but it hits 155 very fast. One of the things you see when you drive in Germany, which is where the car is born and bred, so to speak, is the Autobahn has no speed limit, but that's not to say that it's wide open. So oftentimes where the Autobahn is three lanes wide, which is usually where you can go the fastest. I mean, it's no different than driving on the three-lane highway here. And the trucks in the right lane, they're no different than the trucks here. They're doing about 50, 55 miles an hour. And most of the traffic's doing 80. And they're kind of in the middle lane. And then you're in the left lane doing 155. Well, what happens is this truck's doing 58 and the truck in front of it's doing 55. And he pulls out to pass and the guy behind him moves over. And you've got to go from 155 to 80 or 70 or sometimes even down to 55, just like that. And then as soon as the traffic clears, of course, you want to be back to 155. So that's what the M5 is designed to do. It's where the SMG sort of comes into its own because you can come down gears, go back up gears very quickly. And it's really not so much passing as it is just moving with the flow and trying to get the highest average speed that you possibly can.
Now, we were in a 6-speed manual, and it seemed to be very comfortable at about 85 mile an hour.
Well, the car, I mean, at 85, you're just starting to get in the groove, so to speak. The 6-speed manual is something we did only for the U.S. That came from the strong request of the U.S. market from us that we have a 6-speed manual. In Europe, manuals are seen the way they were perhaps 25 years ago here in the U.S. as the cheap transmission. But, you know, we're way past that in the U.S. Cheap cars don't have manuals anymore. Everything's automatic. Now the manual transmission is the mark of the enthusiast, someone who really likes to drive and likes that involvement. And we do drive a little bit more relaxed here. We're not always going for the ultimate speed. And the manual is a great way to interact with the car. So we do it for the U.S. And as I said, it's not done anyplace else.
Now with the car having such high top end, how can you get consumers to just really appreciate the fact that obviously in the U.S. you can't drive those kinds of speeds. So what do you do to really appreciate other features on the automobile?
Well, we talked a little bit about the driving experience. You asked me, you know, what was it like driving out? And it's that sense of one with the car. And just even at 55 or 65 miles an hour, or roads like these maybe where your average speed is more like 80, you just have that great sense of involvement and enjoyment with the car. It's not just about speed. The acceleration is great. A lot of people think of, I mean, for them, they experience strong acceleration across an intersection, so what we'd call 0 to 100 feet. So basically it's just that, you know, intersection drag race where you see what the other guy's got. Or 0 to 4 seconds, which is, going to be 50 miles an hour, actually almost 60 in this car. And that's about all people really can do in the U.S. most of the time. We find with our customers, they talk about their favorite entrance ramp and their favorite exit ramp. That's where they actually get to enjoy their cars the most. And interesting enough, if you talk to our German colleagues, they have the same. Because just going fast straight on the Autobahn, after all, actually gets old. It's just about that's just about making time. The real enjoyment comes in the entrance ramps and the exit ramps. And it's not the ultimate speed. It's how fast for the particular situation and a sense of control.
So. Now, is the M owner, is that their primary vehicle, or is that for people who have really discretionary income? Because it's not an inexpensive automobile.
It's not an inexpensive automobile, but what you find with Americans, especially people in the U.S., they have multiple, most of our customers, whether it's the 528, the 535, the M5, the 550, they're a multiple car household anyway. Oftentimes they'll have an SUV, hopefully an X5 or an X3. They'll have something like an M5, and they might have a 7 Series, or they might have a 3 Series, depends on the family. And they'll use it as the M5 as their primary car, except maybe if it's winter. So when the weather's really bad, they'll drive it in the winter, but not when it's snowing. Or particularly bad rainstorm or something, maybe they take the X5. But most of our customers are multi-car households. But for most of them, the M5 is essentially a primary car.
Now, what are some of the changes between the 07 and the 08 M5?
Well, the biggest change, of course, is in the interior. We changed the door trim panels quite a bit. We've upgraded the control system, the iDrive controller. We've got 6 programmable buttons now, which basically allow you to put frequently executed functions in a easy one-button push. Change the climate control a little bit to give you more direct access into the menus. From the exterior, we changed the front, the headlamps. We put, for instance, we've moved the turn signal down to here, so we get a full white front light. A lot of our customers like the full front white lights. Many of them were buying European lights and putting them in the cars, so now we've made it legal. We changed the rear a little bit as well. The front of the car smiles a little more. We turned up the ends of the front spoiler, so now basically the car's a little bit happier.
And what excites Rich about the new M5?
You know, I think it's when you open the hood and you really look at the engine technology, it's pretty amazing stuff. I mean, one of the things that people aren't aware of is, for instance, we've got cylinder-specific knock control, and that's pretty common, where basically you want to protect the engine against detonation. The problem is you've got a 10-cylinder engine that spins 8,400, 8,500 RPM. The pulses come so fast that a knock sensor, a traditional knock sensor, can't figure it out. So our M engineers actually figured out that the way the spark forms across the spark plug gap changes depending upon whether there was detonation or not, called ionization of the charge. So the computer system actually measures the waveform of the spark and determines if there was detonation that way. So there's no knock sensor. It uses the spark plug as a knock sensor. And it can do it cylinder specific, and it can detect knock in a cylinder and control it fast enough that the next time that cylinder fires, even at 8,500 RPM, the timing has moved. It's things like that. They're all over the car. The suspension's been changed. The axle carriers get changed. The geometry gets changed. They go through the car from one end to the other. It's not just a 5 Series with a big motor.
Tell me a little bit about what happens when you push the M button on the steering wheel.
Well, what we did is we've got the car's very customizable for the way you like to drive. So we usually try and make it so the car starts in a relatively what I'd call benign state. So it's at 400 horsepower. Usually you want the suspension to be its normal, even comfort setting. You just want things kind of normal. But if the mood strikes you and you say, hey, I want to push this a little bit harder, there's a whole lot of things that you can adjust. So instead of making you go through all those adjustments again, you can set up your favorite profile, and it's all on the M button. So now you just push the one button on the steering wheel. Everything's the way you like it. Go drive fast. And when you're done, you just push the button again, and you go back to the normal mode.
Great. Rich, thanks for taking the time.
Thank you.
This is Roosevelt Gifts with Auto Network, and you're here in Death Valley with BMW for the rally for the 5 Series Intro 2008 model. And as always, please buckle up, don't drink and drive. See you next time.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it. You have a business card on you?